In the heat of a sultry Indian day, they like keeping cool in one of Tadoba's water holes. Unlike Asia's other big cats, tigers love to get wet. We still haven't figured out what turns a tiger into a man-eater. The most enigmatic of big cats, so endangered, yet so dangerous. Their special allure has won them some devoted allies. Harsh and Poonam Donwati are a husband and wife team of honorary wardens at Tadoba Andhari.
Tigers are simply beautiful. There's no other animal that can match its grace. The suspense that builds up, suddenly you get this glimpse of this most fantastic animal, yellow stripes. It's beautiful. It is the king of the jungle.
Savannas are bred with varying degrees of wildness in them, which is measured by the filial system, a formula for measuring the percentage of wild genes in each cat. The F1 is 50% wild cat. When you take an F1 female and breed that to a domestic cat, you have an F2, and so on. Their servile lineage produces some very long legs, which makes them appear to stand as tall as a medium-sized dog, and they have black tear marks running from the corner of their eyes down to the whiskers.
And the purpose of this is actually to reflect light when they're hunting, and this actually comes from the genetics of the wildcat that's been bred into them.
And those huge ears work like radar, spinning 180 degrees and allowing them to hone in on their prey. And being from the wild, they come with some odd noises.
They also do this thing called a snake hiss, which can kind of take you off guard.
While all cats growl and hiss to express distress, the Savannah has a more extreme hiss. It's closer to its days in the wild, where it would imitate the snake hiss in times of danger.
In central India, Tadoba Andhari is one of 48 reserves set aside to give tigers the space they need to survive. 241 square miles of forest, with only about 72 Bengal tigers. But more than 40,000 people live just outside the reserve. There's no way to keep people on one side and tigers on the other. Those 72 tigers have attacked more than 150 people since 2006. In 2008 alone, the number peaked at 21. One of the highest in India that year. Nearly half are fatal, and the tiger ends up getting caged or killed in return.
In ancient Siam, the Siamese cat was considered sacred. Only Buddhist monks and the royal family were allowed to have the cat. During the 1800s, Siamese royalty began giving the cats to visiting European dignitaries. The rest of the world became enchanted with this magnificent feline.
Incredibly long and skinny, like a supermodel. Incredibly beautiful almond-shaped blue eyes.
Deep blue eyes are the most striking characteristic of the Siamese.
Their eyes are amazing. I mean, some of the blues are like Elizabeth Taylor blue.
Some Siamese cats are also cross-eyed.
And this is actually a defect, so most breeders will select against this.
Cross-eyed cats have poor depth perception and limited peripheral vision. In recent years, two distinct lines of Siamese cats have been developed, the traditional and the modern. Modern Siamese cats have a long, sleek body. Traditional Siamese have a rounder body and an apple-shaped head. All Siamese cats are born white.
Siamese have an interesting coloration because they're partially albino. So when they're born, they're white and then develop the coloration.
And those points or coloring on their head, feet, and tail distinguish the Siamese. Variations include seal point, blue point, chocolate point, lilac point, red point, tortie point, and lynx point.
And their coloring, it's beautiful. It's amazing.
The Siamese cat draws attention no matter where it goes.
Filmmakers and field guides spent 16 years following a family of lions whose male offspring became known as the Mapohos. They witnessed extraordinary behavior as the Mapohos embarked on a devastating quest for territory.
That moment where they took over their first territory, that was the start of the bloodbath.
These six males would conquer more land than any lions before them.
They were savage in their approach,
eliminating any threat to their reign.
We estimated that they killed more than 100 other lions in 1 year.
The Mapohos were unprecedented in their aggression and violence. Their story exposes the rarely seen dark side of lions and their constant struggle to survive.